What are the parts of a human ear? Have you ever flown in an aeroplane? What about climbing a mountain or diving to the depth of a sea? Did you know that all these things have something in common? They all involve a change in the altitude that can create a painful clogged feeling in your ears. Actually, our ears perform two sensory functions: hearing and maintenance of body balance. So, let's learn about the structure of a human ear. Anatomically, the ear can be divided into three major sections: the outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. The outer ear consists of the pinna and external auditory meatus or canal. External auditory meatus extends to form a tympanic membrane or the eardrum and composed of dense connective tissue. There are very fine hairs and wax secreting glands in the skin of the pinna and the meatus. The middle ear contains three ossicles called malleus, incus, and stapes, attached from each other in a chain-like fashion. The ear ossicles increase the efficiency of transmission of sound waves to the inner ear. A Eustachian tube helps in equalizing the pressures on either side of the eardrum and connects the middle ear cavity with the pharynx. The inner ear is known as the labyrinth, is composed of two parts: bony labyrinth and membranous labyrinth. The membranous labyrinth lies within the bony labyrinth and is filled with a fluid called perilymph. The coiled portion of the labyrinth is called cochlea. The cochlear membrane divides the bony labyrinth into upper scala vestibuli and lower scala tympani. The space within cochlea is called scala media and is filled with endolymph. The organ of Corti is a structure located on the basilar membrane of the cochlea and contains hair cells that act as auditory receptors. The inner ear also contains a complex system called vestibular apparatus, located above the cochlea. The vestibular apparatus is composed of three semicircular canals and an otolith organ consisting of saccule and utricle. The base of canals is swollen and is called ampulla, which contains a projecting ridge called crista ampullaris. The saccule and utricle contain a projecting ridge called macula. Crista ampullaris and macula are responsible for maintenance and balance of the body and posture. Let's answer a few questions asked in the medical entrance exams. Question 1. Eardrum is 1. Tensor tympani, 2. Scala tympani, 3. Tympanic membrane, 4. Scala vestibuli. This question was asked in Delhi PMT 2010. Solution: the synonym of the eardrum is the tympanic membrane and is composed of hair and wax secreting glands. Hence, option 3 is the correct answer. Question 2. The cavity of the middle ear is connected to the cavities of mouth by a tube called 1. Nasal cavity, 2. Eustachian canal, 3. Perilymph, 4. Basilar membrane. This question was asked in AFMC 2007. Solution: Eustachian tube connects the middle ear cavity with the pharynx. The tube helps in equalizing the pressures on either side of the eardrum. Hence, option 2 is the correct answer. This concludes our video on the structure of human ear. Students must remember various parts of the ear and their functions. Please like, share and comment on the video, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. For more interesting and educational videos to earn while you learn, download Extraclass app from Google Play Store and get rewarded for studying.